Welcome to my channel. Please don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to get updates on any new videos on my channel. Please watch this new tutorial for the lid of basket.
Okay, I'll show you how to make this cover. Okay, I'll be using 9mm. You can use 10mm if your yarn is thick. Check yarn. Okay, you can use cord as well. See here, I have cord, either polyester or cotton cord. Okay, it's up to you. Or you can use ribbon yarn as well. I show you ribbon. Okay, this is the ribbon yarn, also polyester. Actually, this polyester ribbon yarn. There is also cotton ribbon yarn. Most of my items are made in Turkey. Okay, so you can choose which one yarn you prefer. Okay, this is the t-shirt yarn. Sorry, t-shirt yarn, corded yarn, ribbon yarn. Okay. So it's up to you which one you prefer. So for now, I'll show you how to make it with t-shirt yarn. Okay, and how to make this basket cover. Okay, so let's start with making the tip. Start with the tip. Okay, so magic circle, chain one, make one, 2, 3, and 4 single crochet within the magic circle. Pull it tightly. Okay, and then slip stitch to close the round. Make sure you close this round a little bit tight. Okay, and then chain one, single crochet within that stitch. Okay, the V, single crochet. Okay, single crochet onto the next stitch. Not on the loop, but on the stitch here. See this V, the stitch in here. See the diagonal one or the vertical one. Okay, in between the two vertical. Okay, you see here, this is the stitch where you make. Okay, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So single crochet each of the stitches. 4 and slip stitch to close the round again. Okay, on that very first stitch in there. Okay, so this is it. So it's up to you. See here, you can continue to make it a little bit higher. You can continue one more, but here I will stop in here. I'll make the increase already. Okay, so you make increase in here. So chain one, make, sorry, on the very first stitch you make 2 single crochet in there. 1, 2, and to the next stitch make 1 single crochet. So here it's a bit difficult, but little bit of patience. So okay, and to the next stitch you will make 2 single crochet. to the last stitch, you will make one single crochet. So you will be having 6 stitches here. Okay, see, close the round. Okay, so you will be having 6 stitches in there. So now, on that 6 stitches, chain 1. We'll be making 2 single crochet each of the stitches already. So now we'll have to mark the stitch in here. Okay, put marker in that stitch so you know it will be your first stitch later. Okay, so make 2 single crochet here on the very first stitch. On to the next, make 2, and each of the stitches you make 2 stitches. Okay, 1, 2. Continue doing until you reach the last stitch. On this row you should have 12 stitches. Continue until you reach there. I'll see them. Okay, in here, see, before the last stitch, okay, you will not make yarn over through to close. You make a slip stitch on that back of the very first stitch. You see here, not on the chain 1, but on the very first stitch you have done earlier, yarn over, pull through. Okay, that is how to close the round. Okay, and then put the marker on the back, and then the first stitch you make 2 single crochet. And to the next will be single crochet, multiples of 3 stitches here already. Okay, so you will have 18 stitches in here. 1, 2, and to the next will be 1 single crochet, and to the next will be 2, 1, 2, and to the next will be 1. Okay, to the next will be 1, 2, the next will be 1. Okay, continue doing it. 1, 2. I'll show you one more time how to close the round. Okay, and 1. On to the next will be 1 and 2, and to the last stitch will be 1 stitch, and close the row. Okay, this is how to close the row. Okay, yarn over, pull through. Okay, see, this is your 18 stitches already. Okay, so continue doing until you get the same size of the bottom. Okay, same size of the bottom, and then on the last row, for example, this is 36 stitches, you make 1 or 2 more rows of same stitches on the last row for this edging. Okay, for the edging of the cover, and then make slip stitch. That's a little bit very easy actually. It's a very easy actually. So continue. For example, you want a big cover, you can do that. Okay, and stop on the same size of the base. Okay, wait, I'll show you how to do that. See here? Okay, you see here? This bottom is same size of the bottom here. Okay, see, so the cover, you stop on how many stitches you have made here on the bottom. you stop here to make the shape cover. Okay, see how is it? Okay, so it depends on the size of the base you have. So make it as the same size of your bottom. Okay, so keep on doing until you get the size in the pattern. It is mentioned how to increase to make it bigger. Okay, if you want the wooden base, okay, you can have it with 3 mm or 5 mm thickness. It's up to you. Okay, I also sell them on my supply shop. Okay, but I send it to you without the logo. Okay, there will be no logo. Okay, I don't put logo on my supply. Okay, so you can sell it. If you want to sell your finished item, you can put your you can attach your own logo later. So I only supply plain one, no any logo at all. Okay, so I'll show you how to cast on as well later in the other videos. Okay, so let's continue doing this until we get same size with this small one. Okay, to show you how to make the last part. Okay, so continue doing. We'll make here on the very stitch, first stitch, we'll make 1, you can make 2 here, 2, 1, 1, or you can make 1, 2, and 1, it's up to you. Okay, so let's make it with 2, so 1, and 4. So you will have 24 stitches around. So I'll see you there when you reach this part. Okay, this is the last stitch. Okay, you should have 24 stitches. So see the V stitch, you can see here the V stitch. Okay, it's very clear actually, the V stitch. You have to make the stitch on the here in between the V. This is V. You make the stitch here. You see, you insert here. The norm, you insert it here. Okay, the normal single crochet, you insert it there. Okay, this is the normal single crochet, but here you make here. When we make the baskets for this cover, V-stitch, you put it there. Okay, so now let's continue on to the next. Okay, you follow the pattern, what is mentioned in the pattern, how to increase in every row. Okay, continue until you reach the desired size. Okay, so continue doing. I'll see you on the last stitch. Okay, so increase until you get the row. Okay, so this is row 6, small, same as this. So after the row 6, okay, put your marker there, and then you will make 1 or 2 more rows of same stitches, number of stitches as your last row. So here I have 36 stitches, so I'll be making 36 stitches. Okay, single crochet each of the stitches, no increase, no decrease. Okay, You can make it with one row or two rows for this single crochet of stitches. It's up to you, okay, how you want this to be. Okay, so I'll make it mostly on one single crochet, one row only for the extra, and then I do it with slip stitches after. Okay, so here I'll show you with one single crochet each of the stitches and one row, continue doing. Okay, okay, after making the last stitch, okay, you will not make slip stitch here already for the last one. Okay, just pull it from there. Okay, and then you can make your slip stitches around, slip stitches around, single crochet each of the stitches. Okay, you just pull it like that. Okay, turn over your work. See here, it's already the same as that. See, okay, so you make single crochet slip stitches, sorry, slip stitches, just make slip stitch like this all the way through. Okay, slip stitch all the way through. Okay, just make slip stitches all the way through like that, same as this. See, you have that result in there. Okay, so I'll show you how to do it with another style. Okay, I'll show you with another style, back stitch. Okay, chain one, yarn over, pull through, chain one, slip one, yarn over, pull through to the next stitch, chain one, skip one, yarn over, pull through to the next stitch, chain one, skip one, yarn over, pull through to the next stitch. Okay, you can do like that as well. Okay, that is another way to make your reverse stitch, or you can make like this. Okay, you can make reverse single crochet like this. Okay, chain one, yarn over, pull through the loop. Sorry, pull through the loop, and then, okay, single crochet. It's a reverse single crochet. Insert to the next, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through. Insert to the next, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through. Insert into the next, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through. This is the reverse single crochet as well. Okay, you can do that for the finish. Okay, it's up to you, but for me, I prefer the back loop stitches only. Slip stitches only. Okay, so I'll do like that. Okay, slip stitches. All the way through. Okay, so no need for me to elaborate on that. Okay, so do it until you reach this last stitch in here, and then connect here to close the round. Okay, I'll show you that later. Okay, this is the last stitch already. Okay, this is the last stitch, so take out the yarn from there, cut it, pull it from there, the very first slip stitch you've done earlier. Okay, insert your hook from there, take a smaller hook, it's more easy. Okay, insert your hook from there. Okay, and then pull it from there. Okay, and then insert your hook from back or bottom to take that loop in there. Okay, see, I hope that's clear. Okay, see, sorry for that. Okay, see? Pull it from there. Okay, that is too close, see? It's a nice finish. Okay, see that? And then hide it from there. Any extra yarn. Okay, you can use your darning needle or you can do it like this to hide it if you don't have darning needle. Okay, you can do it like this to hide the extra yarn. Okay, so now you can cut it after making it like that. Okay, so here we remove that marker. Okay, that any extra yarn so you can hide it. Okay, lid now, it's ready. Okay, so you just have made a very nice cute lid, so you can make as big as your size of your basket. Okay, see in here. Okay, isn't it cute? See here, sorry, here we have, here we have, here. Okay, so you see, now it fits the same one. Okay, even if I have used different yarn, see, because the base should be the same. Okay, so that's it. It's very easy actually to make the cover. So any questions, please don't hesitate to ask me. Okay, so you can use this cover with any round basket, any size, it's adjustable. So this is very important for you to make your own covers, basket lids. Okay, basket lids or basket covers. Okay, so as I have mentioned earlier, you can make it as big, you can make it as big, the same size, it should be the same size of your bottom. If you use wooden base, so you crochet until you reach the same size of the wooden base. Okay, so that's it. Thank you and have a good day. Please don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to get updates on new videos as well. Thank you.